only on pay-per-view.
And Spring Stampede is shaping up as one of the great WCW pay-per-view events of the year. At this point in time, we have really just details on one official matchup for the April 11 pay show, and that will be the finals of the ongoing WCW United States Heavyweight Title Tournament.
I thought it was going to be Schiavone and Heenan in a cage match. After Thursday night, I thought they were going to tie it up.
Do you think there's any chance of a three-way with me involved?
Go for it. I'll call my cable company today. Are you kidding me?
What got into Heenan Thursday night?
I don't know, as long as he has to come out of it wearing a dress. Good night, nurse. Well, the Disco Inferno has made his appearance on Saturday night, and listen to that ovation for Disco. The bag carrier from the NWO Wolfpack, the Super Soup, Disco Inferno, to face Bobby Blaze.
And Scott, while we're talking about upcoming WCW events, like the Great Spring Stampede Show, we want to remind fans in Fargo, North Dakota, that Nitro is headed to the Fargo Dome on Monday, April the 26th, and tickets are already on sale at the Arena Box Office and Ticketmaster outlets throughout the Dakota.
Disco Inferno has them wrapped around his little finger here on Saturday night. Oh, please tell me no. And once again, Pinter just gave up the mic.
Yo, 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 D-Dog is in the house, so let's kick it one time like this. Let me speak on this. Oil of Olay.
This is a shame.
Arriba la Rasta.
Oil of Olay.
You know, it's Saturday Night Fever, and D-Dog's here, and I got my underwear hanging out of my pants tonight, so you know that I must be bowdy, bowdy, and rowdy, rowdy.
Does that deserve comment?
Only to the point that it's absolutely ridiculous.
I agree.
And the mockery that he made this past Monday on Nitro continues right here on WCW Saturday night.
Unbelievable chain of events Monday on Nitro when the Disco Inferno came out to the announced position there in Cincinnati and just begged not to show the Conan video. Don't throw me in the briar patch. Don't show the video. And sure enough, the video comes up, and there's Disco. Somehow has green-screened himself into the Tequila Sunrise, ruining it. That's a great tune.
You know, we've come to expect that from the NWO, whether it's taking over satellite feeds or putting their own spin on Conan's video like Disco did this past Monday. However, when they got down to the action in the ring on Nitro, the matchup between the Disco Inferno and Conan, it was blatant out-and-out interference on the part of Disco's Wolfpack teammate, Lex Luger, that allowed Disco to score the win.
And let's not forget the involvement of that Jezebel, the coin of Dusty Rhodesism, Miss Elizabeth, distracting the referee as Lex Luger KO'd K-Dog with that cast.
What did Disco call himself? D-Dog?
D-Dog. Side headlock from B-Dog, Bobby Blaze. Hammerlock reversal by the Disco Inferno. Nice counter and escape from Bobby Blaze. Disco looking for a way out. Blaze gives him one right into a side headlock.
And probably no coincidence that since Disco Inferno became an official member of the NWO Red and Black Attack, the Wolfpack, that his one-loss record has really taken a turn for the better.
Oh, absolutely. When you've got 10 guys backstage running interference for you, you could win a match. I could win a match.
On Nitro, it was the win over Conan. Followed that up on Thursday's Thunder with a victory over the Disciple in a matchup where both men have very similar finishing maneuvers. Of course, the Disciple loves to use the Apocalypse, while the Disco favors the Last Dance.
They have other similarities I heard you mention also, Mike.
Well, you think back through their careers and the point in time when the Disciple, well, prior really to joining the OWN, and you think back to where Disco is now, you can really draw an awful lot of parallels in the specific roles that they played in professional wrestling.
No question about it. Disco Inferno not appreciating the abilities of Bobby Blaze and complaining to the referee, Billy Silverman. Come on! Referee, do not pay attention to the Disco Inferno. Now Blaze drawing back that right hand. Oh, Disco into the cut. Elbow to the back of the head. Sets Blaze up. Reversal. Disco into the rope. Oh, a handful of hair from the Disco Inferno.
One thing that we have noticed is we see Bobby Blaze just pull Disco into the corner and put the shoulder block into him repeatedly, is that since Disco has been aligned with the NWO Wolfpack, he seems to be able to maintain his direction, his concentration, and his focus so much more than before.
We see much less crimping, worrying about his hair, hip shaking and whatnot. Disco Inferno, lateral press, hangs on. No, only got the two. We said all along, Mike, and I know you agree, that Disco Inferno was always a very, very capable wrestler. He just could not maintain his focus. The NWO, to their everlasting credit, they have given Disco focus.
And I think that maybe just goes with the territory as far as Disco's concerned. Knowing that big, sexy Kevin Nash, knowing that Lex Luger, they will want to find out if there's a loss by Disco, what went wrong. I think he's brought his game up several notches. Quick cover and a one count, primarily because of peer pressure from people like Nash and Luger and the other Wolfpack members.
Well, Disco does have the NWO to thank for whatever manner and degree of success he has achieved of late in World Championship Wrestling. Reverse chinlock now on Bobby Blaze. Fans, don't forget, later on in this broadcast, World Tag Team Championship on the line. Chris Benoit and Dean Malenko defend against the former champions, Kurt Hennig and Barry Windham. Four of the best this sport has to offer are going to tie it up here on Saturday night.
That was quite a contest last Sunday at Uncensored. Of course, Arn Anderson coming down to ringside when he noticed that Kendall Windham, the brother of Barry Roll-Up by Blaze in a two count, was involved as one of the Lumberjacks.
Yeah.
Arn Anderson, Double A, the enforcer, evened the score and had quite a say in the outcome of that tag title match.
He certainly did. Oh, Blaze misses the drop kick as Disco Inferno held onto the rope. Back press, hooks the leg, only got the two count on Blaze. Now Disco just throttling Bobby Blaze right there, right out of the NWO Wolfpack playbook.
Look at that again. Blatant chokehold right in front of our official Billy Silverman.
And you see Disco, if you're wondering why Disco is dressed the way he is, that is a Conan tribute ring outfit. The underwear sticking out of the top, the black and white camouflage. Now Disco stomps his way into the corner. Blaze is prone in the center of the ring. Disco sets him up, gonna drop the elbow. Oh, and Blaze caught it right in the face. Disco, lateral press, hooks the leg. Disco could do it. No, Blaze out at two.
I thought he had Blaze beaten at that point in time, but the young man was able to kick out. Bobby Blaze has impressed us on WCW Saturday Night broadcasts in the past. We've told you before about the success that he's had in smaller promotions around the country, an opportunity for Bobby Blaze to turn it up a notch here against the Disco Inferno on Saturday night and prove that he belongs in WCW where the big boys play. Standing drop kick by Blaze.
That right foot of Blaze caught Disco flush in the jaw in that drop kick. Disco is staggered into the rope. Blaze, high knee. Nailed Disco in the chest. Snapmare takeover to the center of the ring. Blaze into the rope. Drops the elbow across the chest of Disco. Lateral pass. Hooks the leg. Thought that may have been it. He got a two count.
Nice series of moves by Bobby Blaze, putting three and four together. Coming up with a near fall. Disco just shoved him off that time into the corner. There's the last dance.
That is it. It used to be the Chartbuster. It's now the last dance. And the press hooks the leg. That is all she wrote for Bobby Blaze. And Disco Inferno scores another victory for the NWO Wolfpack.
Now we have to go through this again.
Great. Do not adjust your set. Disco is not having a nervous breakdown.
Oh, it was bad enough Monday on Nitro. We heard it earlier, and now we have to watch him still make a sham and a mockery. Absolute lack of respect for Conan.
Why would you want to antagonize the K-Dog by doing this sort of machination? There we go. Well, at least it's his own music.
There's only one reason to try and antagonize Conan under these circumstances. It's because you're the Disco Inferno.